Hello, everyone. My name is Jin Zhang. I'm the product director for VC Formal at Synopsys. Today, I'm speaking with Kiran Kumar, who is one of the most influential formal leaders in the industry. Kiran is an Intel fellow who leads the Formal Verification Central Tech Office in the Product Enablement Solutions Group. In his role, he drives broad formal adoption on IP and SoC formal verification across all Intel design organizations. Kiran has published a book titled Formal Verification, an Essential Toolkit for Hardware Designs, which is referenced in many university courses. Kiran has one patent, over 100 publications, and 15 plus best paper awards. Kiran also wrote the foreword in the second edition of the Synopsys Formal Verification book titled Finding Your Way Through Formal Verification. Thank you so much for joining us, Kiran. Welcome.
Hey, thank you very much, Jin, and thanks for having me here.
Yeah, so since our first edition of the book released, we have witnessed a lot of growth in formal space in the last 5 years. You know, a lot of adoptions in companies large and small. What are some growth drivers in your mind?
I think the first thing is there is a need, right? I mean, no verification is complete. Mm-hmm. And that's where formal really adds the value. And that's the mindset change that I've seen in the past 5 years. So all these companies mm-hmm. Have realized the strength and potential of formal. And now everyone is embracing this. While we talk about the need, we also talk about the way how tools have evolved over a period of time, right? So earlier, the barrier to enter into the formal verification was very high. There was a concentrated effort from both the industry as well as the academia as well as the vendors that the formal verification entry, the barrier has to be lowered. And we see a lot of people using formal verification now. And while there is a need, there is also a supply. So the demand supply matches now.
Mm-hmm. So the needs and the supply on the supply side, you know, I see a lot of formal apps that simplify the formal adoption, right? Without user having formal expertise. I think those are all helping with formal adoption brought in the market. Now, looking into the future, I know you mentioned some of the leading edge applications in the forward. And one of the things you mentioned is architectural verification. I'd like to hear from you why you think it's important and what gaps we see today in this space.
That's an excellent question. So if you see in any of the products, when we start with the architecture, the feedback for the architects comes only after you implement it and through the verification. And these architecture bugs are so corner case, and it needs a very high volume validation before you get the feedback for the architects. And sometimes it also happens that you will only find it in the silicon. And that loop is a very large loop. In typical industries and in typical companies like Intel, it almost takes like 3 to 5 years. And that feedback is so wide, right? And we need to actually solve the problem right at the source. So today we do have certain tools to validate the architecture, but nevertheless, nothing is complete. And formal verification for the architecture is something that is the need of the hour. Now we are in the age of like the fast-paced innovation age, where we are trying to get so many products at much faster pace. So you cannot take chances, and hence you need to verify the architecture right at the beginning, and formal verification has that strength. And that's where I was mentioning that we need architecture formal verification, and that's going to actually take the formal verification to the next level. In next 5 years, if we are talking, yeah, we'll be talking about the architectural formal as granted, right? So
I'm looking forward to talking to you again 5 years from now and see if that becomes a reality. But I hear you that really shift left is what you're trying to achieve with pushing formal more to the architectural space. That's a great vision. Switching to the organizational perspective, you are probably leading one of the largest formal team in the industry. And I know there's a significant shortage of formal talent. Many companies are trying to recruit or train their engineer to become formal expert. What tips and insight you can share with the industry here on how you have built up your formal team?
There are two aspects to it. One is I need to show the results before I could actually ramp a team. So as you rightly pointed it out, we do have gaps with respect to the technical expertise available in the industry or available in the market. So there is no point in actually waiting for that expertise to come up. So we said, let's solve the problem. And we have created a 3-month training course where we start from the basics of the system Verilog to introducing the formal verification to the sign-off, the solving the high complexity problems, and how do you really get the coverage, and then how do you really finally sign off. And apart from that, we also have a 3-month internship kind of a program where we where these people who get ramped up are on the live project for some time. They get trained on a live project before they are put into the field, right? So it's almost like a 6 to 9 month rigorous process where we train the individuals and thanks to the lot of talent. I mean, the basic idea here is you need right problem solving skills. Mm-hmm. And we were able to get a lot of talent from the industry who have good problem solving skills, and then we started doing this. And at the same time, we were also able to produce the results so that there were more investments coming in from the management, and that actually fueled us to, it's a cycle effect, right? So we show the results, we get more investments, and then we hire people, and then it's a good cycle. It's a cycle in the positive side where we were able to get this. And at the end of the day, the results speak. And our concentration was more on getting the results.
Yeah, sounds like the results excites people to want to, right, take formal as a career path, and excites the management to encourage more, you know, formal engineers in the organization. It's definitely the upward cycle that you're talking about. Thank you again, Kiran, for speaking with us. And for our audience out there, if you're interested in the second edition of the formal verification book from Synopsys, please follow the link on the video. See you next time.